2017. Also like to welcome troop 87, their scout leaders. They're here with us tonight. This time I'd like to ask Reed Bona to come up front, lead us in our pledge. Reed.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Reed. This time I'll call on Robert Taylor Jr. to lead us in prayer.
Yes, Reed. Good gracious eternal God, we thank you for this day. Thank you for this day's blessing. Thank you for letting us see a day that we've never seen before. And for that, God, we tell you thank you. We ask that you bless the families and the friends and everyone that was touched by the massacre in Texas. Touch them right now like only you can. Lift them up for their now, give them strength for the weak. Bless our service men and women here and abroad. Bless those that make decisions for this country and bless us to make the right decisions. This is our prayer in your son Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Robert. Mr. Porter, please show. We do have a quorum tonight, barely. Bill Eskew is absent. Dennis Moody's absent. Carolyn Norman is absent. Next item on the agenda, approval of minutes. Entertain a motion to approve the minutes from October 2nd, 2017. Motion from Mike Morgan, our second. Second from Robert Taylor Jr. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carries. Next item on the agenda, unfinished business. Is there any unfinished business? No unfinished business. New business. Next item, attorney invoice that was attached in your agenda. The amount for the attorney invoice, $11,850. I entertain a motion to approve that.
So moved. Approved.
Motion from Bob Kirk. Is there a second?
Second.
Second, Terry Glover. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carries. Next item on the agenda, selection of airport engineering firm, airport committee chairman Dennis Moody in his absence tonight. Turn to that. Every 5 years, and Greg Williams is here if you have any questions. Every 5 years, TDOT Aeronautics Division requires us to select an engineering company in this packet. This was in your packet. Selection of firm for airport engineering services. TDOT requires that airports go through the selection process every 5 years. Statements of qualifications from engineering firms were solicited for engineering services for airport-related projects. Barge, Wagner, Summer, and Cannon has successfully provided engineering services for our airport for the past 5 years. Responses were received from three engineering firms, Allen and Hoschel, Barge, Wagner, Summer, and Cannon, and SNME. Responses were reviewed on October 9, 2017 by the selection committee composed of Tommy Gibbons, airport manager, Alderman Dennis Moody, airport committee chairman, Mayor John Holden, Tiffany Hurd, city engineer, Scott Ball, construction inspector, and Greg Williams, purchasing agent. The responses were evaluated and scored by the committee. The committee chose Barge, Wagner, Summer, and Cannon as a recommended firm and wishes to enter into a five-year contract. The state of Tennessee requires approval by the Mayor and Board of Aldermen for this selection, and that was a unanimous selection by the committee. And at this time, I'd entertain a motion to accept them to provide continuing engineering services to our airport.
So,
motion from Kevin Cheney. Is there a second?
Second.
Second, Robert Taylor Jr. Any discussion?
Mayor, that was based on the experience we've had with them for the last 5 years, primarily, you think? They've done a good job. Is that correct?
Well, they scored highest than the other two that submitted applications, and personally, I think they've done a good job.
Yeah. Thank you.
Any other questions? Have a motion and a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carries. Next item on the agenda, we have two resolutions that relate to the home grant we got in the amount of $500,000. It was brought to our attention by the state of Tennessee that we need to pass these two resolutions to move forward for the home grant. The first one is resolution 11062017, and the second one is resolution number 11062017A. The first one is for lead-based paint inspection services requirement from THDA, the state of Tennessee, that we pass this. I won't read all of it. And then the second resolution is a resolution adopting the program policies and procedures for the city of Dyersburg's 2017 home rehabilitation program. That's also a state of Tennessee and a THDA requirement that we pass both of these. I would entertain a motion to approve both of these at this time.
So moved.
Motion from Robert Taylor Jr. is our second.
Second.
Second from Mike Morgan. Any discussion?
Mayor, how many homes would you guess that this has improved over the last few years that we've done?
This is our third one, is that right?
This will be starting our third. We probably have worked with about 20 homes.
20? Yeah.
Last year, we only had 375,000.
Yeah, and we won't know until we go through the process how many homes that will be able to be helped this year.
Thank you.
Any other questions?
Who seconded the motion?
Robert Taylor, I believe. Mike Morgan.
So it went from 375 to 5, is it?
Yes, sir. We got approved for another round, $500,000. Yes, sir. That's the maximum amount, $500,000. There were 11 communities across the state of Tennessee that were approved, and we were one of them. Any other questions? Have a motion, a second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carries. Next item on the agenda, Recreation Committee meeting that was held October 19, 2017. Chairman Terry Glover. Mr. Glover.
Thank you, Mayor. The Recreation Committee met Thursday, October 19, 2017 at 10 a.m. at the Dyersburg Activity Center. Committee members present were Mayor John Hovland, Terry Glover, Dennis Moody, Alderwoman Carolyn Norman was not present at that time. Other Alderman board members, Mike Morgan also was there. Staff and others present, Andy Baker, Parks and Recreation, Brandon Hutchinson, State Gazette, Craig Williams, Purchasing Agent, Steve Anderson, Treasurer, Scott Ball, Stormwater and Construction Inspector, Tiffany Hurd, City Engineer, Brian and Megan Gilbert, and Blake Hill, representing the 2016 Dyer County Leadership Project, Barry Frazier, Frazier Roofing, Josh Rogers, Billy Rogers, Plumbing and Heating, and Air Conditioning Incorporation. Recreation Chairman Terry Glover opened the meeting with prayer and was followed by a discussion of the construction progress in place, replacing the roof surface with HVAC equipment at Dyersburg Activity Center main building. Mr. Barry Frazier reported that the new roof project was 99% complete, and Frazier Roofing would be starting work on the concessions building roof repair Friday, October 20th. Mr. Rogers noted that the HVAC equipment installation was proceeding according to schedule and the installed work will be completed very soon. In further business, the committee discussed the potential Dyersburg Dog Park project for Dyersburg. Megan Gilbert provided a detailed overview of the proposed park. She noted the project had raised a current total of $6,318 to support the startup of the park. The committee discussed major issues concerning park supervision and rules, Recreation Department management, city liability and insurance, waste control, and disposal water, water access and supplies. Tiffany Hurd informed the committee that the park design will be incorporated into the Fort Deer River Park Plan under the oversight of the National Disaster Resilience Grant. Both Mayor Holden and Andy Baker shared that each had spoken with the other mayors and Recreation Department in various communities. All testimonies were positive as to the value and use of the park. Mayor Holden motioned to approve the dog park project as presented. Alderman Dennis Moody seconded the motion, which passed and will be presented to before the board of mayor and aldermen. In other reporting, Andy Baker updated the committee on fall sports events. Mayor Holden acknowledged the city's work in renewing the former senior citizen building, and Tiffany Hurd and Scott Ball provide an update on the current progress of the NDR grant. With no further business, the meeting adjourned at 10:40 a.m.
Thank you, Mr. Glover. Out of that meeting, I guess we need a motion to approve the dog park.
So moved.
Have a motion from Mike Morgan. Is there a second?
Second.
Second from Terry Glover. Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? Motion carries. Next item on the agenda, Public Safety Committee meeting minutes, October 27, 2017. Chairman Bob Kirk. Let me pause just a minute. I ran through that real quick. If you want to say something, we've already approved it.
Yes.
Yep. hesitated for a minute, you gotta be fast.
I was sitting there trying to figure out what was going on.
Understand.
And I should raise my hand.
We had the same problem.
I'm not here to oppose the dog park. They're gonna be our neighbors. I represent Damascus, and I think the dog park is a good thing, and I think it'll bring a lot of people downtown. So my comments here are not in any way here to be opposition to the dog park. But I would appreciate some consideration to how the dog park is nested into a downtown area. And if I might pass these out, can I do that?
And Paul did call me today and asked that he'd be able to say something.
Yes, I would not have wanted to interfere with the vote in favor of the dog park. The Damascus building, which you gentlemen, this board approved some time ago for a Damascus project, lies adjacent to a green area on the other side of the railroad tracks, which is part of the overall development area for the, whatever you call this, major downtown initiative. And we were excited when we saw the building, and that one of, for a lot of reasons, but not least of which, was it was right next to a large green space, which we understood was part of the downtown park area. And that because the building, the Damascus building, would be right next to that, that would provide an opportunity for the men in our program to have a place to get out with their children and on visiting day, you know, throw a ball around, throw a frisbee, have some fun, just get out there and socialize with their kids. Because part of the Damascus initiative is to build families. We want to restore men to their families. We want to build a stronger community through the rehabilitation of not just the men, but the families. And so that's kind of important to us, that they have a place to do that. And we'd like to do it near the building where we can keep our eye on what goes on. Early in the program, we would, as early as possible in the program, the men will be in the program for 9 to 12 months. Early in the program, we want to begin to renew that family relationship to whatever extent possible. But yet they're not, at that point early in the program, they're not able to be trusted, and so we have to keep our eye on them. So it would be nice if there were some green space right near our building. I got out after I saw the article, last article in the paper about the dog park, and finally had an idea of its size. I was kind of surprised, so I got out and I took some measurements, and what I'm asking is if the in the design of the location of the park, if we could spare an area of about 100 by 100 feet right next to the Public Works building. I've given you an aerial view of that area, and if you'll see right to the north of the Fork of Deer River, right next to that Public Works building off of Main Street, you'll see a little black box that says green space, and says 100 by 100. So that's the request that I'm making of you, is that in the design, that this might be a possibility that you could leave some green space for us and others to use. And by pushing it right up against the Public Works building fence line there, I didn't think it would interfere too much with the general location of the dog park. It might require to get the 280 feet that the dog park needs. It might have to wind around. If you look at the end of Church Street and You'll see the parking lot for the farmer's market there, and to the south of the parking lot for the farmer's market, you'll see a tiny little shed. That's a gas valve building. I don't know what it's, what a good name for it is, but the dog park might have to come in behind that building to get the length of run that they're trying to accomplish for the dogs. I talked to Tiffany Hurd, and she said that she wouldn't want anything to interfere with the extension of Church Street down towards that parking lot, because she feels a necessity for that access to remain as accessible as possible. So you can't just go straight across 280 feet. If you were to go from the at gas, well, the total distance from Public Works to the gas building is roughly 366 feet. And so I'm asking if we could carve off 100 feet of that and run the dog park 8 square footage down there. But I'm not trying to suggest where or how the dog park should be placed. What I'm, my only, I'm just presenting that to say it's possible. What all I'm here for is to ask if we could leave some green space at the end of Mill Avenue that would be utilized by Damascus and others. And that's my only request. And I think it's complementary to what we're trying to do with the dog park as well.
Mayor, where are we on the design for the dog park? Is that, how far along in the process is?
Well,
are you doing some work on that?
Well, in your packet is the diagram and the design of that. It's 280 foot by 80 foot. Of course, we have other considerations that we have to take into account, that being the easement away from the railroad. Paul and I talked earlier today in front of his building. Obviously, there's a railroad track that runs adjacent to his building. That it's not an approved crossing per se. And I told Paul that, you know, we're not going to give anybody permission to cross that because it's not an approved crossing. They cross at their own risk. Because if something were to happen, obviously we'd be on the hook for that. We certainly don't want to do that. The approved crossing is at South Church Avenue. And that's behind his building. Also, asked Paul about the green space available, and that's a gas regulator station, Paul, that's in this picture. He's about the green space that's adjacent or in between the regulator station and the farmer's market itself, and I think he has some concerns on what he mentioned earlier about being able to keep a watch on your folks. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay.
And I understand there, yeah, but that will be actually developed into a park area, or that's the plan anyway, that would be developed into a park area with park equipment and so on. And I'm not asking for any park equipment or any expense. I'm merely asking if we can allow some green space to continue to exist, that just some room to throw a football or frisbee around, get out there and have some fresh air with the kids.
Okay, and to answer your question, Mr. Kirk, you know, there it's going to be an overall conceptual design for this whole area down there. That's going to be, the dog park's going to be included in that, and I think we won't know exactly where that location will be until we have that conceptual design.
That's part of the big project south. This is part of that big project for South Town.
It's in addition to that, as we talked about, that space is undevelopable because of all the utility lines and underground utilities underneath it. And I think the leadership group last year had another location or two that they'd inquired about, and we all came to the conclusion that this was probably the best space for the dog park, and also fit in with our overall concept for what we're doing in South Dyersburg with the $7.5 million grant we got to improve that area. And that's how we settled on this space.
Mm-hmm.
I think it'd be fair if, and I told Paul, I kind of got caught off guard today by his phone call and his request, but I think with all due respect, we can be fair as we design that to give consideration to that. It can't, I can't promise that, but.
Of course.
We'll do all we can to try and accommodate you, your group, and as well as the leadership group as well, that's worked awfully hard and raised a lot of money to make this a reality in our community. If that would be fair to you, yes.
And I'm not hung up on that exact size or, you know, if Ms. Hurd said that, you know, maybe she could get work in an equivalent amount of space, but the configuration might look a little different, that's fine.
Okay.
You know, whatever might work, if you would just keep us in mind and try to work in some green space there.
Okay.
I would hope that that's what we'll do, Mayor, and you can kind of steer that in that direction and not to do any harm to the work that's been done for the dog park, but maybe to help accommodate the Damascus program, which is an outstanding program for the community.
Okay, fair enough.
I think we can be good neighbors.
Sure, okay, good deal, thank you. Thank you, Paul, I appreciate it. Anybody from the leadership class want to say anything or any comments? I guess everybody voted approved, that you're welcome to say something, or probably best not say anything about that. All right, good deal. Thank you, Paul, I appreciate it very much. Next item on the agenda, Public Safety Committee meeting minutes from October 27, 2017. Chairman Bob Kurt. Mr. Kurt?
Thank you, Mayor. The Public Safety Committee met Friday, October 27th, 10 o'clock in the Professional Development Center. Members present included Mayor John Holden, myself as chairman, Mike Morgan. Alderwoman Carolyn Norman was not present. Other Alderman board members were Terry Glover. Staff and others present, Brandon Hutchison with State Gazette, various city officials and department heads, including Dyersburg Police, Fire, and 911, members of Motorola, and Jeff Miller, Arnold Hupper, Alan McLean, and Trooper Goff with the State of Tennessee TACN Radio Network. I call the meeting to order to discuss the status and the future of Dyersburg radio system. The current system is scheduled to no longer be supported by Motorola at the end of 2018. Mayor Holden welcomed those in attendance and then turned the meeting over to the Motorola representatives, who made a presentation to the city of a P25 radio system upgrade to join TACN, which means Tennessee Advanced Communications Network. The TACN radio system was launched in 2015 by the state. The following was presented. If the city joins the state system, then the city would be part of the state system that would allow the city to talk within city users and throughout different parts of the state. The second item number two, the proposal also noted that Dyersburg would connect to the Jackson Quadrant on the state system, referred to as the Millsville RF site. City number three, the city would receive new Apex 2000 XE radios. Number four, other benefits would include county and statewide coverage, statewide in priority day-to-day operations of TACN, pay $200 per radio to the state of Tennessee annually, and that the total cost of joining the state would be lower than maintaining the city's own system. It was noted that Motorola would not own the system. However, the state would own the plan. The city would own specific portions of the system. Motorola would maintain the system as a partnership with the state. There would be a cost for this system to get the city updated equipment, but afterwards the majority of the responsibility would be provided by the state. There were additional discussions concerning the cost of previous update in 2011, along with the use of current radios on the TACN system. Motorola representatives presented numerous products, including various models of communications devices. No action was taken by the committee. No further business was presented before the committee, which adjourned at 11:20 a.m. This, I don't think the board needs to take any action, but it's just for informational purposes as we begin to study what we ought to do to increase and enhance our communication system. Thank you, Mr.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mr. Kirk. Bids, Greg Williams, no bids. Next item on the general report from Alderman, Bob Kirk.
Don't have anything, Mayor.
Mr. Glover?
No report.
Kevin Chaney?
Mayor, I got one thing. In the past couple of weeks, I had a couple of citizens come to me or call me about a situation that involved code enforcement. And I just want to say, say that I talked to Kevin Johnson and Thomas Mullins, and they helped me with that and took care of that, and I just want to say I appreciate that very much.
Thank you. Robert?
I don't have anything.
Only announcement I have is Saturday is Veterans Day. It'll be observed as a holiday on Friday, November the 10th. It will also be the day the Veterans Day Parade will be at 10:30 in downtown Dyersburg, starting at 10:30, and lots of groups participate in that. Thank you, Troop 87, for coming and your leaders. We appreciate you being here, working on your merit badge, all the other visitors and folks. We appreciate you being here. With that, meeting adjourned. Thank you.